As we fly over Peru, from Lima to the north, a huge veil of clouds covers the Pacific coast. Here, more than 3,000 meters above sea level, the Belgian Development Agency launched one of the largest forestation projects in South America.
Antes no podían ni calentar agua porque no había leña.
Y ahora, ¿qué piensas? O sea, que ahora ya tienes leña cerca de la casa y ya...
Cerca de la casa, sí, no. ya no traigo desde la banda, ya no traigo.
Before the forests, the landscape looked like this. It's still the same in many parts of the Jalca. It's in these extreme conditions that the first Belgian development workers arrived in Peru in the early 70s. Their goal, to find a way to provide woodlands. There was a lot to do, starting with the construction of roads and bridges to be able to access the land where forests would be planted. Every aspect of the future tree harvesting had to be thought through.
La sociedad, mis asociados no han querido porque ellos pensaban que yo voy a desplazar la ganadería o voy a desplazar la agricultura. Entonces me dijeron, ¿acaso nos vas a dar de comer palos?
Years of research, supported by the Belgian Development Agency and the universities, were necessary to develop techniques that would lead to the most prestigious forestation project in the Peruvian Andes. Don't be fooled, this is not a European landscape. We are not in the Vosges or in the Ardennes. This really is in the Andes in Peru, 30 years after the first planting. To better understand the origins of these woodlands, let's go back to Belgium near a typical Ardennes village. And when we went to Porcon, we saw that people had a significant need for timber, for both society and industry. And so we easily transferred our knowledge from here. In the Jalca, it's the women who collect the firewood. The cooperative has gradually moved to other, more traditional herds on the Jalca, alpaca and vicuna. Related to the camel, they give excellent quality wool, which sells for high prices on international markets. The rearing of these animals goes back to the time of the Incas. The introduction of vicuna to the forest is a new experience in the Andes. A real timber industry has built up in 25 years. Local people are discovering the value of this raw material, hitherto unknown in the Andes. And no doubt it didn't realize what wealth it had in its hands. The international agencies had withdrawn without offering long-term planning. And so, things happened at their own pace, were delayed, until a market became available. And every week, 25 30-ton trailers are loaded using just muscle power. Here, there are no lifts for the workers to rely on. The cooperative is careful to replant what has been felled. Mario Mendoza, a technician trained by the Belgian Development Agency, continues to produce the plants needed in both of the nurseries belonging to the cooperative. University trainees come to help.
¿Usted también ha plantado los árboles?
Claro, lo he plantado, pues. Lo he plantado Yo he hecho hoyos.
Ah, he hecho hoyos también. Sí. Con la lampa.
Con pico para lana.
Yeah. Es duro.
Claro, algunos duro, algunos no, algunos duro, algunos no.
With its booming economy, Cajamarca needs wood. In the 70s, you could count the number of sawyers and carpenters on the fingers of one hand. In just a few years, 700 joineries and 40 sawmills have started up. Mainly furniture is produced, and mostly in Porcón pine. Like Carlos, many other craftsmen have realized that growth inevitably involves more refined processing of wood.
Este modelito está saliendo bastante. Es una cama deportiva.
Yellow gold has served and still serves to fuel global capitalism. Green gold, he believes, can never be uprooted. The green gold of Cajamarca. Can it really be contained in these little cones?